By bringing the stars down to Earth and stripping the mystical veil off of Tarot,
we can now open a window into the self.
You are the magic. These are your tools.
Welcome to Self Mastery,
the practical art of tarot and astrology. Today, we follow the devil to the wrong side of the tracks, to a neighborhood in Detroit known as 8 Mile, where we meet Rabbit, played by the masterful Eminem, who comes from a stereotypical trailer park with his mom. The scene is set there with the devil already in fine form, casting shadows from the past that echo with self-doubt, with lessons that shake the ego to its knees. Loud, he opens his mouth, but the words won't come out. He's choking how? Everybody's choking now. The clock's run out. Time's up, over, loud. Snap back to reality. Oh, there goes gravity. Oh, there goes gravity.
Rabbit escaped the trailer park and his disdain for it once before by moving to the city with his girlfriend. But shortly after, however, he experienced his first tower and his world begins to fall apart. Wherever there is a devil, there's a tower that shows up to rattle the foundation of something that was not built to last, something only the ego is keeping intact. The devil also is a lesson in humility. Rabbit left behind 8 Mile in judgment and with disdain for his mother. A fragile wreck though she was, her circumstances compounded the fight. Strangely, Rabbit left that behind only to recreate that in his own life. Different places, different faces, same cycle.
The devil is ruled by Saturn, the god of time, karma, restrictions, and the past. Saturn abhors repeating cycles, and the lessons get harder each time you repeat. But whatever must be learned must be understood thoroughly. So, Rabbit goes back to the past, to 8 Mile, and into his shadow. Faced with what he can't escape, the devil does what it's designed to do, breaks open a heart that was closed in fear. And what comes out of that break is Rabbit's gift, his poetry. He knows it too. As he says, the soul's escaping through this hole that's gaping. This world is mine for the taking.
Well, Jimmy moved in with his mother, 'cause he ain't got no place to go. And now I'm right back in the gutter. With a garbage bag that's full of clothes. Buzz it. 'Cause you live at home in a trailer. What the hell you gonna do?
Yeah! 'Cause I live at home in a trailer. Mom, I'm coming home to you.
Break it down.
However, it's not gonna be that easy. If only the devil played nice, you know? But that wouldn't get Rabbit to where he needs to go. He's aiming high, so the climb is steep, and he still has a few things he needs to overcome. He doesn't have a job, or a car, or any money. He has to walk to work every day, to a job that he feels is beneath him. Don't we all feel that? But he does it, and so do you. And at night he writes, the devil is also a Capricorn energy, the hardest working sign in the zodiac, the determined goat with a constant eye on achievement. Rabbit decides to take his scrappy raps to the battle stage, reconnecting with his past friends and enemies. The problem, when the devil is present, it can be hard to know which one is which. The problem when the devil is present, it can be hard to know which one is which. The first night out on stage, faced with a room full of his past, Rabbit chokes. He can't say a word. The fear of judgment kept his gift in chains. He opens his mouth, but the words won't come out. He's choking. How? Everybody's joking now. The clock runs out, and another level of the tower falls on Rabbit's ego.
But the thing is, Rabbit has no other choice. There is only one way out of 8 Mile. If he wants to escape the shadows that keep him from reaching his star, he has to keep walking. He has to confront his own temptations to quit, to slip into that low vibrational belief that he's nothing more than the product of his own environment.
Okay, folks, enough with the gay jokes, especially from a gay broke bitch yourself, eh, Lope? this?
Your style's doo-doo. You worked here longer than me, and I get paid more than you do.
Serious, man.
Dog, take a seat. What's this guy standing in line for? He ain't got money to eat.
Of course, he meets another girl who is a mirror of his mother and his self-doubt. A friend who promises him stardom and then betrays him. And a gang of wealthy rappers from the posh side of town who use Rabbit's shame for his past as a weapon against him. He has to confront his own demons if he has any hope of winning the next rap battle.
This beat is still gonna sing. You're a disgrace. Yeah, they call me Rabbit. This is a turtle race. You can't get with me spitting this shit. Wiggity, lickety, shot. Those bridges, wiggity, split, lickety.
And it's a big one that could lead to a recording deal. Now having been held in by the chains of Saturn and his karmic lessons, Rabbit has a chance to break out once more. But this time, he has faced the past. He has faced his fears and the echoes of failure that surround him and the doubts that even his own friends put on him. What if the rapper he's up against, hilariously named Clarence, by the way, brings up his past again? He could choke again, but not this time.
Rabbit has walked through his shadow and come out the other side with acceptance, humility, and a renewed fight. Rather than let his opponent use his history to take him down, Rabbit decides to embrace it. He uses the hard-earned lessons he learned from rising above his past as weapons against his enemies instead of himself, jumping into it before Clarence gets the chance.
Now everybody from the 313, put your motherfucking hands up and follow me. Everybody from the 313, put your motherfucking hands up. Look, look. Now while he stands tough, notice that this man did not have his hands up. This free world's got you gassed up. Now who's afraid of the big bad wolf?
To quote his own lyrics again, this guy ain't no motherfucking MC. I know everything he's got to say against me. I am white. I am a fucking bum. I do live in a trailer park with my mom. My boy's future is an Uncle Tom. I do got a dumb friend, Cheddar Bob, who shoots himself in the leg with his own gun. I did get jumped by all six of you chumps, and Wink did fuck my girl. But I'm still standing here screaming, fuck the free world. Don't ever try to judge me, dude. You don't know what the fuck I've been through.
And in saying these words, Rabbit simultaneously dismantles the whole weapon his enemies can use against him and release himself from the binds of his own shame. Now, after facing the devil, number 15 in the major arcana, having survived the tower, number 16 in tarot, falling solely around him, he can now rise from the ashes of his past and reach the star, the number 17 in major.
Again, Rabbit says it best in his own poetry. Fuck y'all if you doubt me. I am a piece of white trash, and I say it proudly. And fuck this battle, I don't want to win, I'm outie. Here, now tell these people something they don't know about me. With that one final brave admission of his past shame, he puts an end to the cycle that kept him chained to failure, and Rabbit is free.
Look, if you had one shot, one opportunity to seize everything you ever wanted in one moment. Did you capture it? Just let it slip.
The path is inside you, and it's always just beginning.
We are forever grateful to share in the exploration with you. We'll see you soon.
Thank you for listening to Self Mastery, the practical art of tarot and astrology.